In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to set up SoundFlow with Stream Deck. If you don't already know them, Stream Decks are very powerful external keyboards that have an LED screen behind every key so that they can display colorful icons and text labels. Using the Stream Deck software, these buttons can be programmed to integrate with many different applications, including SoundFlow. So how do we get this set up? There are three different ways of setting up Stream Deck and SoundFlow with each other. The first option is by using the Stream Deck app. This is how most people start out. The second option is by designing your decks inside SoundFlow and then use SoundFlow's Stream Deck plugin to connect them together. The third option is our recommended option. This is where you design all of your decks inside SoundFlow and where SoundFlow connects directly to your Stream Deck devices without using the Stream Deck app at all. Now, why would we recommend you to use our direct integration instead of Stream Decks? The primary reason is, it's much easier to set up. Just follow the instructions on screen. It takes a minute, and you're fully set up. Reason number two, the SoundFlow Store. By letting SoundFlow control your Stream Decks, you get access to all the pre-designed decks made by our community. To install a deck from a package, just find the package and click Install. We have tons of free packages available. For example, our popular dialogue editing for Isotope, Audio Suite decks, and many more. Reason number three, no local files. If you design your decks inside SoundFlow, all your settings, decks, macros, and scripts are stored in one place, in your SoundFlow account. So when you get to a new computer, there's no complicated setup and no manual copying of files that you need to remember to back up and synchronize. Just log into SoundFlow and your whole personal workflow is instantly available. Reason number four, advanced trigger types. If you design your decks in SoundFlow, you get access to our advanced trigger types, for example, window triggers. With a window trigger, you can have different decks depending on which window is focused in an app. For example, you can design decks for each of your Audio Suite plugins, or have a different deck for your edit and mix window, or when a certain folder is open in Finder, your Stream Deck can change automatically. Reason number five, dynamically generated decks. In SoundFlow, a script can take temporary control of your Stream Deck and use it to show dynamic content as part of an automated workflow. For example, here's a script that dynamically shows the open Audio Suite plugins, so I can batch process a chain of plugins on my selected clips in Pro Tools. Reason number six, it just works. Well, this was also in part the first reason, but perhaps it's the most important one. Because it's easier to set up, it just works. And the final reason, number seven, is speed. Using SoundFlow's direct integration with the Stream Deck, there's no app in the middle to slow us down, so drawing on the Stream Deck is incredibly fast. Okay, so enough reasons. Let's get on with setting it up. First, click the SoundFlow icon up by your clock and select Setup Stream Deck. Click the first option, Use Your Devices Directly from SoundFlow. Now, we have to make sure that the Stream Deck app is not running so SoundFlow can control the devices. Click Quit Your Stream Deck app. The next step is making sure that the Stream Deck app doesn't start on every boot. Enter your administrator password when asked. And finally, restart SoundFlow to accept the new settings. Now, if you've used the Stream Deck app before, you may have given your devices names. In this step, we need to help SoundFlow understand which device is which. Here I have three devices. Stream Deck Left is the green one, Stream Deck Right is the red one, and Stream Deck XL is the blue one. So I click green for Stream Deck Left, blue for Stream Deck XL, and red for Stream Deck Right. And that's it. On this final page, you can see the names you've set for each device and control its brightness on the slider. Now you can click close to close the window. If you want to go back to this page and change the setting later, you can always click the SoundFlow icon and choose Setup Stream Deck. That's it. Happy SoundFlowing.